take the sunrise, sprinkle it with dew. Cover it in chocolate and a miracle or two, the candy man, oh, the candy man can.
Yes, the candy man can, cause he mixes it with love, it makes the world taste good. My name's Willy Wonka, I make chocolate. Quite simply, the greatest invention in the entire history of the world. Whoever could there be who doesn't love the tooth-tickling, tongue-tastical taste of a sweet bar of soft milk chocolate? Except dogs, of course, it's poisonous to dogs. There comes a time in every chocolatier's life, when the chocolate he makes turns dark, and bitter. And that's when he knows it's time to lay down his spoon, to hand it over to someone else, someone new. The only question is, who can take a rainbow, wrap it in a sigh, soak it in the sun and make a strawberry lemon pie? I need to find a new me, a candy man. Who can catch a candy man? Oh, right. The world. I haven't been out there in a very, very long time. Well, what are you waiting for? Let's go!
Not him, kid. Willy Wonka. What happened to Willy Wonka?
happened next?
Oh, he died.
What?
He died.
Well, that's hardly the same thing.
You see, Wonka found out that to his sad surprise, the workers he cherished turned out to be spies. They copied his recipe, spoiled his art. They sold all his secrets, and worse, they broke his heart.
Willy Wonka turned his back on the world. He shut up shop and left his factory. They say he hates all humanity.
Nobody thinks to knock. Maybe give the guy a call.
Well, it's a factory with no workers, but somehow he still makes chocolate. How does he do it? No one ever goes in, and no one ever goes out. It's one of the greatest mysteries of the chocolate-making world.
Who cares how the stuff's made as long as kids buy it?
Oh no, only old people like his chocolate now.
What?
Wonka's old-fashioned. He's out of date. He's not even advertised on TV.
Imagine.
And so it's been decades, and Wonka's grown old. Like I told you, it's like he was dead. Then I saw the shop, and then lo and behold, the explosion you heard was my head.
Mr. Crockett Duck!
Grandpa Joe, it's me.
Oh, Charlie! I thought it was back at the Alamo.
You were dreaming.
Dreaming? Oh, me never! I was resting my eyes. I was wide awake, like a coiled spring, ready to pounce.
Well, pounce on this. Look!
What's that?
The wrapper of a Wonka, Wimple Scrumptious, Fudge Ball of Light!
Wonka's masterpiece! Where on earth did you find that?
Candy shop just opened up at the end of our street. And guess what? It sells Wonka bars!
Imagine!
Come on, let's put this in my scrapbook. Then we just have enough time to play Willy Wonka before my mom gets home.
Oh, Charlie, you know we're not supposed to play Willy Wonka. Your mom says we'll distract you from your homework.
She won't find out.
Want to tell you a story instead? How about the time I was a travel agent for a Mr. Lewis and Mr. Clark. A weekend break in the hills, they asked for. Lovely gentlemen. I wonder what happened to that.
Please, Grandpa Joe, please. You know what sort of story I want.
All right, but shh. You mustn't wake other grandparents. I'm an old, old man with a tongue that can tell a different tale for every year. But when I ask this boy to choose what story he'd enjoy, Willy Wonka is what I always hear.
My name is Willy Wonka. I make chocolate. How would you like to be my security guard?
It would be an honor, sir.
Perfect. And now I make the chocolate.
I have fought world wars, cycled 10 grand tours from the shores of Wales to Tripoli. But when I asked this tot to choose one story from the lot, Willy Wonka is what it's all to be. Because Charlie Bucket's an awful lot like me.
Delicious.
Charlie, when I, we make something out of nothing. Me and you, Charlie, we see things that aren't there. Charlie and I wonder how, but never why. Yes, me and you, Charlie, Charlie, you and I.
And then red sugar and raisins and marshmallows and meatball.
Have you two been playing Willy Wonka again?
No. Grandpa Joe was just helping me with my history.
Geography.
History of geography.
I was sharing with Charlie the benefits of my extensive expertise.
I wouldn't believe one word your grandpa says, Charlie. He makes them all up.
All my stories are true.
True?
Every one of them would stand up in court.
You couldn't stand up anywhere. Joe, you've been stuck up in that bed for 40 years.
I'm not stuck. I'm merely awaiting my call to arms.
Well, at least your arms work, I suppose. So you can use them to peel the rotten leaves off that cabbage for me. Charlie, wake the others. It's time to eat.
Dinner!
Oh, lovely.
Oh, God. Oh, are we still here?
Put your bibs on, everyone. It's dinner time. Grandpa Joe? Grandma Josephine. Grandma Georgina. Grandpa George.
What is for dinner tonight, my dear?
Cabbage surprise.
Didn't we have that last night?
That's a surprise!
I don't mind cabbage soup, but you know, it makes me gassy.
Somebody kill me.
Pass the soup, Charlie.
Here you are.
It's cold.
Well, winter's coming.
I'll light the stove.
There's no wood.
I found an old chair leg down on the garbage dump.
A chair leg? See? We'll be warm as toast.
For tonight, at least. Oh, and Charlie. Look what else I found when I was down at the dump.
A new notebook!
All blank pages. A little water damage.
Perfect for inventing chocolate.
Perfect for homework.
Ah!
Inventing candy's fun, Charlie, but you need to earn a living. A person can't eat daydreams, you know.
I know.
I'll check your answers when you're done.
If five boys have X bars of chocolate, and each bar has y squares. And x is 2 times y. Then how many squares of chocolate does each boy have? Oh, I can't. Wait, I've got a better idea. Dear Mr. Wonka, I know that you're a busy man. You must have lots of mail to read. I'm writing for my family, 'cause there's nothing special that I need. The time you take to read this letter will be time well spent, because I've made a list of things you might want to invent. How's your homework? Almost done. That's my Charlie. That's my son. For Mom, who's always on her feet, you might please grant me this one wish: to keep her shoes attached to her, some laces made of licorice. For Josephina, I have drawn a recipe beneath. For molars made of marzipan, and she can't find her teeth.
Have you scrubbed up?
Yes, I did.
That's my Charlie. That's my kid.
Charlie, I'm off to work the night shift. Will you look after those reprobates for me?
I will.
Thank you, Charlie.
When I was smaller than I am, my daddy took us to the sea. He bought my mom an ice cream. She was happy as a mom can be. For her, I would invent an ice cream that would never melt, so she can feel all day what I wish she always felt. For Grandpa George and his Georgina, something not in any store. Some pillows made of marshmallows to keep the noise down when they snore. For Grandpa Joe, who soon is turning 90 1/2, a joke book made of jelly beans, 'cause he just loves to laugh.
Off to bed now.
What is it?
The headlines! Look!
What does it
What does that mean?
No, start with Grandpa Joe.
Wonka!
Factory to open.
At last.
Dolphin!
That factory's been closed for years.
Read what it says, Joe.
Renowned chocolate maker Willy Wonka has announced an amazing contest. Inside, some of the many chocolate bars that leave his factory every day, he's hidden five golden tickets. Find one of them, and you can win a dream trip to his chocolate factory for a tour conducted by Mr. Willy Wonka himself.
Oh.
A
brain-boggling, mind-mangling, snoz-tastic prize!
Jen!
Is it Jen?
Enough Wonka confectionery to last an entire lifetime!
Wow! Why, every child in the country will want one of those tickets.
Every child in the world.
Not just children, seniors too.
Oh, Grandpa Joe, imagine.
No imagining. That's enough daydreaming, you two. It's time for Charlie to get off to school.
Oh, Mom.
Charlie, we can't afford any kind of chocolate right now. Never mind Wonka bars. It's no good dreaming about something when it can't possibly come true. Off you go then.
Wait! Mom, it's my birthday soon, isn't it?
It's right!
That's true!
And every year, on my birthday, I get one bar of chocolate, don't I?
He does!
One bar of chocolate. That's one chance, isn't it?
It is!
Not this year, Charlie.
What?
Last night, Mrs. Walensky cut my shifts at the laundry. She's gone and bought a machine. She only needs me for delicates now. I'll find more work, but in the meantime, we just have to tighten our belts. We haven't a cent to spare. I'm sorry, Charlie.
That's okay, Mom.
So, I want to be late.
Now look here! I know times are tough, but a birthday's a birthday, and a kid ought to have a present on his birthday, ought he? Especially that kid, Charlie.
Joe.
Now, it just so happens, I've managed to save up quite a bit of money over the years. 79 cents, to be exact.
No! That money's supposed to be for your funeral.
Pump me in a trash bag and put me on a Tuesday, Josephine. I don't care about funerals. All I care about is Charlie, and he ought to have a chance at a golden ticket.
But Grandpa Joe, my birthday's not for 29 and a half more days. All the golden tickets could be gone by then.
Gone? What kind of spirit is that? Remember the story I told you about hunting rhinos in Africa?
With Dr. Livingstone, I presume?
That's the one. Do you remember what he told me? Joe, he said,
when rhinos charge,
never waver.
Stand your ground.
A wise man, Dr. Livingston.
Whatever happened to him?
Well, he was killed by a rhino, but that's not the point. The point is, stand your ground. And there's a golden ticket out there with your name on it, Charlie, that it'll find you.
Bucket, want to buy some chocolate?
No.
Why not? Everyone else does. Haven't you heard about the contest? They're calling it Wonka Mania!
Of course I heard about the contest. But I don't even want to think about Wonka until I can buy my very own bar. As far as I'm concerned, No news is good news.
I completely understand. Mum's the word. Shall we turn on the TV? Chocolate news.
Fuck it! Look!
What?
We interrupt this program to bring you breaking news that the first Wonka ticket winner has been found. To find out more, let's go right over to our chief confectionery correspondent, Cherry Sunday. Cherry, where are you?
Cherry, I'm in Bavaria. And here in this sleepy mountain town, it seems like a chocolate dream has come true for a local butcher's son and three-time regional Bratwurst eating champion, Augustus Gloom.
Oh, go ahead, my little pumpkin, smile for the camera.
This is a story of hope. How could it go?
Oh, when I was just a girl, I used to dream of a maid who would bring me lots of sweets and put some sausage on my plate. Mr. Gloom was quite a meal, but now he seems just like a crumb, cause it turns
She likes ballet. She's the daughter of a peanut billionaire and
I made his announcement, my Veruca expressed a very keen interest in the contest. She said,
I want that ticket now!
How could I possibly refuse? When Veruca says,
more,
I buy another store. And when Veruca says,
now,
the sweat forms on my brow. And when Veruca says,
again,
no matter where or when, we better all kowtow to,
more, now, again.
When Veruca says,
out,
there's no reasonable doubt. And when Veruca says,
fetch,
there's no time to convention. And when Veruca says,
obey,
you'd better find a way to make it a ruthless stretch for,
out, fetch away.
Now when she heard the warmest price, she started to a tick. So I told my peanut shellers, here's a tougher nut to crack. You've each 1,000 Wonka bars, start shelling them at once. For when Veruca's hippie, it's much better for her peppy. For 40 days and 40 nights, the ladies tried to pick it. And always to the music of,
I want the golden ticket! I want the golden ticket!
And then a worker stood and in her hand the panacea. The golden ticket on display, what did Sir Veruca say?
Daddy,
yes,
by North Korea!
When Veruca says,
spy!
It's like a battle cry for when Veruca says,
mine!
What a chili for a spine! And if Veruca said,
please?
I know it was a tease before a mortal
now out my fetch bite!
When she finally falls asleep, I pray and say amen! Till tomorrow when it all begins!
Again!
Bucket, aren't you impressed?
Two changes gone.
Only 3 tickets left. Everyone in the world is eating Wonka chocolate. Apparently, he's a global brand. I don't even know what that means. It sounds amazing, doesn't it?
It sounds terrible. Soon, there won't be any tickets left.
Tell you what, Bucket. When you're right, you're right.
Oh, there you are, Charlie. I knew you'd be hanging around that darn candy store. Here, give me a hand with this laundry. And later, I'm gonna need you to go down to the dump and fetch a piece of tin or something. There's a hole in the roof and a pigeon's been pooping on Grandma Josephine's head. Charlie, you're thinking about those golden tickets again, aren't you?
I can't help it, Mom. I just want to see inside that factory. Oh,
Charlie, there must be a million kids just like you.
Nobody could want a ticket as much as me.
I know, but there's nothing you can do about it. You just have to cross your fingers and hope.
Chocolate news!
Bucket, look!
No!
Breaking news, we have our 3rd golden ticket winner. From on the story, let's go right over to our chocolate news hound, Cherry Sunday. Cherry, where are you?
Cherry, I'm in California, where the lady luck has landed in the lap of local gum celebrity, Violet Beauregard. Oh, and here comes her daddy now. Mr. Beauregard, would you like to make a statement?
As a matter of fact, I would.
It's time to meet a little lady everybody's talking about. Now she is royalty of the highest order, and she don't give a hoot about what the root says. Cause around here, daddy has the last word. Okay?
My daddy says that I am blessed. My daddy says that I'm a star.
That's right.
My name's
bullying young lady. She certainly is not afraid to toot her own kazoo.
Three changes gone.
Mind you, I'm not surprised. According to the paper, Wonkamania is taking over the world. Whole countries are torn apart as warring factions scramble for Wonka bars. In Rome, on a safe visit, even the Dalai Lama spit on the Pope in a scramble for the last toffee crisp. I guess llamas really do spit. What do you think about that, Buckets, Buckets? Well, time to dilly-dally, dear boy.
Lots of love and wriggling, not to mention love.
Molly.
Can you tell what it is? Can you tell? Can you?
A Wonka, Wimple Scrumptious, Fudge Molly Blake!
That is your favorite, isn't it?
Yes!
Well, aren't you gonna open it?
What if there's a golden ticket? I can hardly watch.
I can hardly breathe.
Well?
Is there a ticket, Charlie?
No.
Oh.
Thanks, Mom.
Happy birthday.
Let's share it?
You have it, Charlie.
I know. I'll eat it slowly. Last year, I managed to make my birthday bar last for 6 months. Ooh, you make this one last a whole year.
I lit the candle. Don't you want to blow it out?
You blow it out, Mom.
Don't you want to make a wish?
I only had one wish.
Poor Charlie. We should never have let him get his hopes up.
What hopes?
It's all my fault.
It's not your fault, Joe. Poor Charlie never stood a chance.
Speak to him, dear.
Mama, I don't know what to say.
Oh, well, you'll think of something.
Charlie, you can't help dreaming. It's in the bucket blood.
If your father were here, he would say that one's Mars. He would hang you the moon, and then he'd mount all the stars. I would say, brush your teeth. Is that dirt behind your your father were here? If your father were here, you would not be in bed. He'd be acting out the stories from the books that you've read. He'd be walking the plank of Charlie Bucket, Buccaneer. You'd be silly if your father.
Oh, Wonka, what chocolate whirlwinds have you stirred up upon the world? Crazed children lust for sugar.
Greedy adults are beguiled by gold.
It's not so much an apocalypse as
an chocolate.
As the nation is gripped for a desperate hunt for chocolate, the world asks, upon whose infant brow will Dame Fate place her final golden kiss? I'm Jerry Jubilee.
And I'm Cherry Sunday.
For Chocolate Tonight, say,
stay safe out there.
Cherry, we're live.
Ah.
Ah, there you are. I thought you'd kick the bucket, Bucket.
Are you leaving?
Of course. All the chocolate's gone. I'm closing up. Every last bar, bonbon, and marshmallow chew in the shop sold. Isn't that wonderful?
I suppose.
Well, there's no suppose about it. That Willy Wonka is a marketing genius, if I do say so myself. Grab that broom. Help sweep up. Put your back into it.
What do you think he's like?
Willy Wonka? How should I know?
I mean, what does he do all day? Does he write his ideas in a notebook? Does
Does he sit all day in class and daydream?
Well, not class, I suppose, because he doesn't go to school.
Does he? But does he just spend his lunch break mixing things up in cups to see how it tastes?
How does he do it? What happens inside that factory?
There's still one chance left.
Not for me.
Oh, Bucket, don't be disconsolate. You've been a witness to history. Trust me, one day this will make a great story. Well, it's been nice knowing you. Actually, here.
Wait, what? So much cash!
Thank you. We missed a bit over there. So long, Bucket. Remember, no man waits for time. Don't carp and seize the per diems. Bye.
Goodbye.
A dollar. Sir, you left a dollar. Sir! Sir! He's gone.
Vegetables. Vegetables. I'm back to selling pressing old vegetables.
Mrs. Green.
I suppose you want dinner, kid. Well, got a couple of squishy tomatoes in here. They won't look too bad if you just wipe off the mold.
Mrs. Green, what happened to all the chocolate?
It's all sold out, kid. There's not a Wonka bar left in the whole country.
But I got a dollar.
You come into your inheritance, Rockefeller.
I just wanted one chocolate bar.
Well, let me see. I think I got a couple of second-rate Prodnos chocolate bars down here in the bottom basket. They're probably staying, but wait a minute. Look at this.
A wibble scrumptious sludge mother delight. Please may I buy it, Mrs. Green?
Must have slipped down the bottom of my bag during the good times. Don't eat it all at once, kid. Vegetables, vegetables. Some so rot you could eat them with a straw and call it a smoothie. Get your liquefied vegetables here.
I should take it home and share it. Just one teeny nibble. Just to be sure it's okay.
Amazing thing.
I got a golden ticket. I got a golden sun up in my sky.
This is going to be a disaster.
That's what the Captain Titanic said when he had me take the wheel. I never thought I'd see the day when it would face the world and say good morning. Look at the sun! I never thought that I would be slapping the lap of luxury as they all said.
It shouldn't be done.
Bring me my jacket.
But it can be done.
And my pants. I never dreamed that I would fly over the moon in ecstasy, but nevertheless, it's there that we're surely about to be. Cause we got a golden ticket.
We got a golden ticket.
We got a golden chance to make our way. And with a golden ticket, it's a golden day. Charlie?
How'd you do?
How do you do?
Is that all?
Sorry.
Woo! There you have it. Looks like a loser to me, Jerry. But you know, maybe you'll leave with a bonbon.
Poverty's such a terrible thing. Wasn't it Jean-Paul Sartre who said, L'enfer est...
Shut it, Jerry. It's time.
Ladies and gentlemen, the clock strikes. The hour has come. In the shadow of Wonka's factory we stand, but where is the man who created it all? From whether the shadowy confectioner who was hidden in his sugar-coated Shangri-La for over 40 years, the man they call...
Won't you help me, please? I'm afraid that I might fall or my eyes and knees have grown frail behind this wall. Let me come to you, though it appears I've lost my pep. But has this ancient relic read in the Tao of Qing it said? A journey of 1,000 miles begins with just one step. Beyond this door is a factory. From just a beam. Beyond the store, surprises in store, but it must be believed to be seen. Beyond the store's invention, where mind meets with the machine. Beyond these gates is a world I create, but it must be believed to be seen. No magic spells, no potions. Swear the shared domain, my kingdom created from notions, all swirling inside of my brain. Beyond this door's a banquet of Wonka-made cuisine. A lucky few will get to pass through, but it must be believed to be seen. Beyond this door is come dance betwixt and between. Beyond this vault is a world without faults, but it must be believed to be seen. Beyond this door's a puzzle, you'll find out what I mean. Beyond this gate is a world I create, but it must be believed. My childhood home was bland like yours, but I knew how to look to find a world that wasn't colorblind. Let's hope that you're a bit like me as you walk through my factory, for in the end there's quite a prize.
All I've achieved,
it must be believed.
flowers actually bloom. The trees change flavor in the fall. And in the winter, it snows powdered sugar. You can even milk the giraffe and get pina colada milkshakes. It's either something out of a dream, or where I grew up, or maybe I just imagined it. And I don't know anymore. Your eyes are the first to see it. A room made completely and entirely out of candy.
Grandpa Joe, now I know I'll never have to dream again. For I've had dreams incredible, but here's a dream that is edible.
Mr. Walker.
Boom. goodbye.
You never tried to make a friend,
but now we'll have some fun.
This will suck.
Oh no, your tour is at an end.
Our joy has just begun. Twice round, twice count, time to make the fudge. Stretch, strain, cause pain, time to make the fudge.
I'm telling you! Things up. Why, you never know what you're going to get next. Only yesterday I was mixing together a batch of bananas with some uranium.
Uranium?
Actually, we also do that in Russia.
I was aiming to make a lollipop that you could suck and charge your phone with at the same time, but in fact, I got this. Beautiful, isn't it? A complete waste of time, but beautiful nevertheless.
You could use it for reading comics at night.
What?
Oh. You know, in the dark. And read the covers.
What's wrong with using a light bulb, Dumbo?
We don't have electricity.
What?
You could call it liquid sunshine.
That's not a bad concept.
I'd buy it.
See?
Well, now hold on. Cool your jets, Bucket. There's blue sky thinking, and then there's just plain loopy. Liquid sunshine would never work. It's far too practical, don't you see? Oompa Loompas, whip up 2 barrels of liquid sunshine. Fast. And get the pet. Thank you. Now, that's enough clever ideas from you. Who would like to hear more delightfully silly ideas from me?
Yes!
Furry Lollipop Fly.
You might not... Sucking sucks, Wonka. Why haven't you got something I can chew?
Chew?
I want gum.
It's what she's famous for, Wonka.
Well, I don't have gum, but I do have this. Gastromolecular Unicellulose Mouth Mulch, or G-U-M. It's like gum because you chew it, but unlike gum because it contains the flavor and nutrition of a full 3-course meal. Pie for dessert.
That sounds amazing.
Doesn't it?
This could completely revolutionize Violet's brand.
It could, Mr. Beauregard, but it won't.
Why not?
There's a problem with the blueberry pie.
What's the problem with it?
Excess fructose in the fluid sex.
What?
Too much juice. You get any other pie, pumpkin, Boston cream, mince, you're fine. But if you get blueberry, Berry.
Bad.
Ugh, I don't care about dessert, Wonka. I care about fame, and this stuff's gonna make me huge.
Violet, no. You tell him bye.
Tell me, Daddy.
Tell the people what you taste, Violet.
Chicken soup. It's delicious.
Violet, you are going to be the face of gum.
Mr. Beauregard, it's just a prototype. It's still very dangerous to eat.
Roast bacon. Mashed potato?
Oh, don't worry, Wonka. We'll cut you a deal on the image rights.
Violet, please spit it out.
Spit it out? Don't you know who I am?
You are talking to the queen of pop.
Okay.
Yes, Mr. Beauregard, but if she proceeds...
What is the pie?
Pie?
What kind of pie? Pie.
Blueberry. Blueberry? Uh-oh.
What?
I swallowed it.
It'll be fine. Oompas, we have a potential fructose expansion incident in the mixing room.
I don't feel so good.
Wonka, what's happening to her?
She's blowing up.
She's getting fat.
One more kid nuked.
I need to go to the bathroom.
This can't be right.
She's drinking the blueberries. No.
This can't be right.
Wonka, you've got to do something.
Well, I admit Violet turning into a blueberry was not in your plan. But you always did say you wanted her to be huge. You always did say she was unique. Haven't you actually gotten exactly what you've always wanted?
No!
Look here.
You got what you want, you don't want what you got. You had your last meal and it sure hit the spot. For once upon a time the queen was so hot to trot. And so you got what you want.
Now you need to stay, you'll be feeling for.
Because you got what you want.
She exploded!
A moment in the spotlight, and then, alas, her bubble burst. Let that be a lesson to us all. But don't thank me, Mr. Beauregard. There isn't time. Follow the Oompas down to the juicing room and scoop up what's left of her out of the pulping pots. Quick as you can. We don't want her to ferment. Signal's clear, don't you?
What am I supposed to buy now?
Maracas. Chin up. Next, we're going to visit the special cupboards where I keep all the secret ingredients.
Wow.
But first, to get there, we must pass through this maze full of deadly traps. I'll just punch in the code. This way, please.
You mind that?
Oh, really?
You're sad.
Watch your head, Marcel.
That must have hurt.
Now, first, you're going to want to take it left through the sticky toffee swamp, but stay on the marshmallows, or else you'll lose your shoes. Next, you'll want to take it right through the wind tunnel. Hold on to your hats. Then, you're going to want to duck walk nice and low through the frying pan alley. Until finally, you open the portal with a strike of a gong. Easy as pie. Too soon. Now you, Mike.
Ew! Yuck! You're such a loser, Wonka!
What was that, Mike? I didn't quite catch that.
I said,
out of the fire and into the frying pan. Itself.
safe. No limbs lost, only superficial bruising. Veruca, what happened to your face? Oh, it was like that to begin with.
I do apologize.
Come along, Mr. Bucket. No man waits for time.
I don't think I can bend that low, Mr. Wonka. My old back won't take it. Not after Gettysburg.
Oh dear, we can't leave Grandpa Joe behind. I'll tell you what, forget the secret cupboards. Who needs them? Let me show you the nut room. That's so much more fun. It's right this way. Follow me.
He's loopy.
He's Bets.
He's bananas.
He's crazy.
Wait for it. We're here. Welcome to the nut room.
It's the same room.
Evening, Jeremy.
You're bad.
I need to up my prescription.
Cutie, wootie, tootie, Squeedle.
Oh no, Veruca. Jeremy is not a cutie, wootie squirrel. Jeremy is a highly trained mammalian factory operative. He sorts my nuts.
He sorts your what?
Jeremy works in the sorting room with the sorting squirrels. They sort the good nuts from the bad.
Well, that makes sense.
Sorta.
Wait, how do they tell which from which?
Squirrels have a very highly developed sense of right and wrong.
Squeedle! Daddy! I want it now. Squeedle, now!
Okay, Wonka, how much for the rodent?
Not for sale.
Squiddle, 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 squiddle!
Make your price, won't I? We'll double it.
Just one squeewop. Oh, it's over, Wonka.
Yet.
No. No one says no to the Veruca salt!
Veruca, wait!
Mikey!
Charlie!
Wait, stay back. It's simply not safe to go in there.
Thank you.
screaming, I want, I want. Do you think Persia taste will still look cute as she bought all the braves down the badger chute? Baruka salt, the selfish tot, was never good with the things she got.
But it's not just fish, it's Baruka's fault.
This rancid recipe demands another dash of salt.
Down the bad nut chute.
That was so cool.
Oh no.
Can't you get her back? It's too late, I'm afraid. Papa's coming! Don't worry. The Oompas will find a way to stick her back together. They're a whiz with a glue stick.
Mr. Wonka, that girl doesn't need a glue stick. She needs emergency surgery.
That is true, but there's no time to mourn. That's not what Veruca would have wanted. And Veruca always got what she wanted, didn't she? We must carry on with a smile in our step and a spring in our hearts. Advance.
Grandpa Joe, you don't really think Veruca was torn apart, do you?
At this point, Charlie, anything's possible.
Mr. Wonka wouldn't do that.
She was a real pain in the ass.
Even so.
Again, come Twaddle. All aboard the SS Wonka. Isn't she a marvelous tub?
Where are you taking us now?
We're deep down in the bowels of my factory. Right now, we must be some 10,000 feet or so below the earth.
Mr. Wonka, a simple knowledge of geology tells me that's impossible.
Well, a complicated knowledge of geology would tell you the exact opposite.
What about us, Mr. Wonka?
You missed the boat, Buckets. You'll have to walk. Always daydreaming, that boy. It's a terrible habit.
Hey, where are we going?
The future, Mike. I hardly ever visit.
Will this be safe?
Safe? Of course it's safe. Why wouldn't it be safe? You are insured, aren't you?
Yeah.
Whatever. I'm not scared. It's another lame task. It's obvious what's gonna happen. The poor kid's gonna get splatted, and I'm gonna win. Then I'll be on a Wonka Winner reality show.
Well, then you better get ready, Mike, because your future awaits.
Oh.
Uncle Charlie, and should we go on?
Bucket!
Never waver!
And ladies and gentlemen, may I present Chocolate Television! Normal television sends chocolate through space, but chocolate television goes one better. It sends chocolate through space.
Hacha!
That's impossible.
Allow me to demonstrate.
Why does the chocolate have to be so big?
The chocolate has to be very, very big, Charlie, because television makes everything so very, very small. Stand back! Broadcast in 10. Close up on camera 6. Pull back camera 4. Remote telecast in 5, 4, 2, 3, 1. Action!
Oh, it disappeared!
On the contrary, the chocolate hasn't disappeared. It's all around us right now in billions and billions of tiny microscopic particles. Just waiting to be reassembled on this screen. All we need to do now is find the proper channel. A volunteer, Mrs. TV. Channel 209, please.
Okay, 209. Do I hit OK, select, or enter?
Just stick to the numbers.
Oh, now I've turned on the Apple TV.
Oh, give it to me. Useless.
And voila! What do you think?
That's not chocolate television, Wonka. That's chocolate on television. I can see that any day of the week.
Pick it up, Mike.
What?
Go ahead, just reach into the screen.
It's real.
Taste it.
It's really real.
Oh, it's truly remarkable.
Hey, Wonka, you can put chocolate on TV. Can you do it with a person, too?
Well, I suppose, but there may be some technical difficulties.
I'm doing it!
Mikey, what are you doing?
No, Mike, stop.
I'm not just gonna be on TV, I'm gonna be in TV!
Michael, come down from there now.
Welcome to the Mike TV TV show!
God, Wonka, he's gone!
Oh, on the contrary, Mrs. TV. He hasn't gone. He's all around us right now in
billions and billions of tiny microscopic particles.
All we need to do now is find the proper channel. Channel 209. 209. Interesting. Oompas, we've lost him. We're going to need more screens.
More screens? That's the last thing Mikey needs.
Well, this old thing doesn't have enough channels. We're going to have to search cable, satellite, the internet.
Alas, for Mikey, for ONG, he's ADD.
The little people are singing again. That's never a good sign.
He's like so many nowadays. It's awfully modern, this malaise.
That's the problem with the future. Never know what to expect.
Whenever Mikey threw a fit, the TV set would babysit.
Wonka, where is he?
I'm looking.
The only things that Mike can spell are FYI and LOL.
So many channels and nothing good on any of them.
He never goes outside to play. His world is dark both night and day.
Ah, Animal Planet, the Oompas Love a Nature documentary.
The skies are blue, the pinks, the greens. He only views on laptop screens. out of conversation.
Don't spin the story, Mrs. T.
Of what's become of my TV?
From wasting his entire brain.
He's stuck inside his own domain.
He'll channel surf to whereupon.
He'll find that nothing good is on.
And
he can use to find his soul. So please, oh please, we beg and pray.
Throw your phones and text away.
And in their place you can install
a lovely bookshelf on the wall.
And later each and every day
to listen to the things you say.
To love you more for what you did.
And you can dance the night away. Idiots. But they're just idiots. Idiots.
TV, Mrs. TV.
My God, Wonka, what happened to him?
He shrunk to fit the screen.
Oh no!
What's he saying?
And it's the most important room of all. A room full of everything you could ever desire. What do you say? Would you like to see it?
Yes, please.
Excellent. Then climb up the ladder of light. Oh, I'll turn it on for you. We must climb up, up, up all the way into the roof.
Charlie, did you hear that? A roof of everything. You know what it means, don't you?
No, Grim Joe, what?
It means you've won. A lifetime supply of chocolate!
Do you really think so?
Of course I do, and you're the only one left.
Bucket! No time to dawdle when wonders await.
Wonders see!
We're coming, Mr. Wonka!
We're coming, Wonka! Oh.
No time to dawdle when wonders await.
Is there oxygen up here?
Welcome to the Imagining Room.
It's completely empty.
Exactly. It's as empty as a blank sheet of paper. This is the room where I come to imagine. Every night I come up here to look out over the town. I wait. And then, when an idea arrives, I just jot it down in my notebook.
You have a notebook too?
Of course. All the ideas I've ever had are in this book, and most of the ones I haven't had as well.
Then you do have a dad?
They're in the back, in the blank pages.
May I see?
No!
But I...
No one gets to see my secrets. I'm pain of death.
Death?
Well, that's a bit harsh.
No punishment is too harsh for spies.
But I'm not a spy, Mr.
Wonka. Charlie's in better too, you know.
That's what they all say.
But!
No buts! That's it. Show's over. We're done here. Mr. Bucket, Charlie, thank you. It really has been the most fascinating trip. We've all been on a journey, haven't we? Lost a few friends along the way, and I think we've all learned something, and that's the main thing. So, if you'll please excuse me, I must be getting on. I have a factory to run. Yoompas will see you out. Adieu.
But Mr. Wonka!
What?
What about Charlie's grand prize?
What grand prize?
A lifetime supply of Wonka candy!
Oh, that. Here. Have this.
A gobstopper?
Suck it slowly. It'll last you a lifetime.
Now, Mr. Wonka, that's not right. Now, you showed us things that we can possibly understand, and you promised a lifetime supply of Wonka candy, not a measly gobstopper.
Measly? Measly? How dare you insult my work?
I warn you, Wonka. I'm a fighting man. Come on.
Stop! Grandpa Joe, this factory tour is the most amazing present I've ever had. I don't need anything else. Really.
Really?
Really?
I promise.
Good! Then, Mr. Bucket, would you care to step into my office? There's a few matters for the two of us to finalize. Confidentiality agreements, health waivers, and so forth, and then you can both be on your way. Charlie, perhaps it's best if you wait here. This is grown-up's business. You don't mind, do you?
No, I don't mind.
Excellent. Then sit here, but whatever you do, don't touch anything. You've seen what happens to the children who break the rules of my factory, haven't you?
Yes.
Good. Sit quietly, then. Won't be long.
At least get a marshmallow or something.
What?
Nothing. Nothing. Charlie, you stay here, and I'll get you a Whipple scrumptious if it's the last thing I do. Wonka!
Charlie, you've done something right.
Right.
Charlie, you've won.
Another crop stopper?
Nope.
A lifetime supply of treats?
Better.
What could possibly be better than a lifetime supply of treats?
Let me show you. Charlie, you and I, we make something out of nothing. You and me, Charlie, we see things that aren't there. Charlie, you and I, we ask how but never why. It's me and you, Charlie, Charlie, you and I. Welcome aboard my great glass elevator. I haven't been in this thing for years. Let's see if it still works. Push that button.
The one marked don't push.
That's the one.
Something crazy is going to happen now, isn't it?
How did you guess?
I love it when crazy things happen.
So do I. When a boy like you looks to the sky, at the stars and planets passing by, if the boy's like me, he'll want to fly into the stratosphere. And as we both rise into those skies, your future will appear. That's why I brought you to see the view. And he walks the streets without a nod. He should know that odd is a gift from God, like the starry blue chandelier. And the more he lives, perspective gives him sight so crystal clear. That's why I brought you to see the view from here. So you could see the Straits Magellan sail, the battlefields where good prevailed, the pyramids, St. Peter's Dome, the tiny house that you call home. Charlie. Look down there in my factory. Do you see it?
Yes, Mr. Wonka.
I love my factory, Charlie. I love it more than anything in the world.
So do I, Mr. Wonka. So do I.
Well, I'm very glad to hear that, Charlie. Very glad, and do you want to know why?
Why?
Because my factory is your grand prize.
What?
I'm giving it to you.
But Mr. Wonka, why would you want to give away your factory?
I can't keep running it forever, Charlie. I had to hand it over to someone else. Someone new. Someone who's honest and kind and likes to mix things up. That someone, Charlie, is you.
My letter!
Charlie.
I cannot
make something out of nothing. You and me, Charlie.
Here. Is it true? I'm a chocolatier.
And Charlie, what do you say?
Mr. Wonka, I can't accept.
What?
Strike that, reverse it. Of course I accept, Mr. Wonka. Of course I do.
Goodness me, is that the time? Come, Commandeer boy. We've got a factory to run. Something wrong.
My family.
Oh, they're already inside. The Oompas turned the entire top floor into a bucket palace. I even gave Grandpa Joe his old job back.
Mr. Wonka, I really would have been happy with just the gobstopper.
Yeah, right. Although it was a good gobstopper, wasn't it? Ooh, you know what would make it even better?
A marshmallow cream center?
I was going to say cheese, but let's go with your idea. Come along, Bucket. You've got daydreaming to do.
My name is Charlie Bucket.